Okay, so this is something I enjoy doing before we even get started, especially because I get you in the afternoon, which I don't know about you, but I get sleepy. So I want to know, show of hands, who in here has danced today? Yeah, I said danced. Oh, a couple of you. Okay, the rest of you are cringing right now and you're terrified, and it's okay. I am going to ask you for 1 minute to stand up and just move with me, and I'm going to tell you the song that was picked comes from my 8-year-old girls, so don't judge. They asked me to play this one for you, and we're just going to see what happens with the cha-cha slide.
Cha-cha, real smooth. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One out this time. Right foot, let's go. Left foot, let's go. Cha-cha now, y'all. Last time to get funky. To the right now. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One out this time. One out this time. Right foot, two steps. Left foot, two steps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth.
All right, let's talk about what happened to your faces, which from my perspective was pretty awesome. What happened between you thinking about dancing and you actually dancing? You guys changed your mood. And I don't know if you felt it, but what was released into your bloodstream were endorphins. Endorphins are so important to your health. When we talk about happiness, and we're going to talk about it a lot today, when we talk about happiness, we have to talk about depression and anxiety right with it. Depression and anxiety are obviously at an all-time high. Some of that is because we're not doing enough dancing. We're not doing enough releasing endorphins. Now, those of you who have still kids or grandchildren, you probably do a little bit more dancing because it's just, what are you gonna tell them? No, I'm too old for this? I'm sorry, but we don't, right? We get up and we dance with them. Well, I gotta tell you, those 8-year-olds keep me dancing. I actually dance when I'm brushing my teeth in the morning. That was probably TMI. I have some clothes on, but I'm up there dancing. Now, part of it is because of what I've been through, and everything in my body hurts when I wake up. But I don't go grab a bottle of Aleve. Instead, I dance. And you guys, I'm telling you, within a minute, my body doesn't hurt anymore. The endorphins that are released block the pain. It's pretty powerful. So if there are a few folks in here who are aging, like I am, or who are survivors, like I am, I'm telling you, just wake up and dance and you'll feel a whole lot better. Movement's a big thing. Okay, let me tell you a little bit about what we're gonna talk about today. We're gonna talk about how to live life loudly and what it means to live life loudly. You see, pain is infused in all of our lives because it's meant to move us off of our very comfy couches that we've gotten used to. And I thought fighting cancer once was a pretty big deal. But apparently I was meant to learn more lessons and my couch was too comfy because I got to do it again and again. And now I know I will probably cause a few tears in here, but I can tell you right now these bones look like Swiss cheese. You wouldn't know it from me dancing, but they do. And I don't get a fourth chance. I get whatever I've got, and we don't know how long that will be. But I can tell you this, I don't live a single day without intention. And if nothing else, when you try to discover how do you find joy in your life, how do you find happiness in your life, I want you to remember that even one day matters. Today matters. So everything I do is intentional. I'm here intentionally. I wanted to be with all of you. In fact, you guys are the reason I finished my second book. Is that amazing? And you didn't even know you had an impact. So what happened is back in May, I gave a keynote speech to a group with HSMAI and MPI in Arizona. And I had been delaying writing the second book because of controversy. The title was causing controversy. And I talked to the group and said, hey, I need your input on this. I think I need to finish this second book. But nobody wants me to put a cuss word in the title. And you'll hear about it, but I can tell you right now, it's do epic shit. It is all about how I live my life. It's how my family lives our lives, because we don't know how many days we get together. So we do epic shit every single day. And I'll tell you what, it's created so much controversy, I literally just stopped writing because I didn't know what to do about it. So I took a poll, and the entire audience, with the exception of two people, said, you have to be your authentic self, and modifying the title is not your authentic self. What do you have to lose? Just go for it. And oh, by the way, if there's an organization that doesn't like it, you can actually publish a second edition that's a softer version. So I've got my backup plan.